y'all. It's Anna. I am in my front yard. I was just taking out my recycling, and I came across a cluster of ringless honey mushrooms. The Latin name for this is Armillaria tibescens. It is incredibly common this time of year in the Piedmont. It is mid to late September. These kind of go off like a bomb once the temperature drops a little bit overnight. And they are a wood decomposer, but they really are vigorous. So you will find them growing on, not only decomposing wood, but also places where trees used to be. So in the case of these mushrooms, there hasn't been a tree here for quite a long time, but nonetheless, they come up here regularly every year. So, I would consider this to be sort of an intermediate mushroom from an edibility perspective. I say that simply because it is a brown, sort of dun-colored mushroom that has gills. And so gilled mushrooms are just much more difficult to get your head around because there are more of them. That said, they're so common and ubiquitous, and once you get to know them, you're not going to mistake them for something else. I would consider them to be a good mushroom to get to know. So primary characteristics, first of all, as I mentioned, it's a gilled mushroom. It has sort of flesh-colored gills, and they brown a little bit as they age, but that is a distinguishing feature. Those gills as well, you'll see they run down the stem a little bit, and that is what's called decurrent. So the gills on these mushrooms are decurrent. Additionally, if you look at the top of the mushroom, this is not always a feature that you will get with honey mushrooms or the ringless honeys, is there's a sort of a little scurfiness or a little, sort of hairy patch right in the middle of the cap. A lot of them vary in color. Like, these are kind of what I would consider to be average. It's not really golden or honey colored so much as I guess it could be a really, really pungent clover honey. But nonetheless, you will find them in, wonderful golden colors, and you will also find them in, brown, black, sock-smelling condition. They do age really quickly, so if you were going to eat them, you should probably harvest them as soon as you see them come up. They don't stick around for very long. So decurrent gills, oftentimes little hairy patch, sort of, honey-ish in color. They also very frequently have a darkening at the end of the stem, so you'll see it's sort of, it's not a staining so much as just the growth pattern of it. And I'm going to pluck this mushroom patch here. So another really, really distinguishing feature, your honey mushrooms, including Armillaria tibescens, is that they grow in clusters. So you have a lot of mushrooms that'll grow in ones and twos, connected to a root system. The ringless honeys just go off like a bomb from whatever they are growing from. That's definitely something that you will notice about them. But additionally, here's this sort of blackening, brownish, base of the stem. So those are the main features. One other thing, I'm going to find the best example I can out of this cluster. The spore print of ringless honey mushrooms is white. And, spore printing is a really good practice if you are, identifying mushrooms, but oftentimes with the ringless honeys, you can actually see the spore deposit on the caps of mushrooms as they're kind of interlocking in that, big cluster. And so, in this case, it's a little bit faint, a little bit difficult to focus on camera-wise, but oh, there we go. So you can just see a little bit of a deposit. But some of these mushrooms get to be very, very large, and you will see a tremendous amount of spores on them. But yeah, this is, I would consider, a pretty good mushroom. This is also one that you will get pictures from people about. So most of the year, people don't notice mushrooms, but they absolutely notice these giant bouquets of brown fungus that come up in their yards. So now you're ready to answer those questions.